Nearly three, bloody hell, time flies. So nearly 3 years now. So Josh is going to talk a little bit about his career path, what he's done, the technologies he's used and where he is now. And we've got Paul. Paul is head of technical delivery at Capgemini. All these guys are from Capgemini. And Arthur, who's software engineer lead, is that right? So they're going to each give you a little bit of information about different roles, different processes, methodologies, ways of working, and technologies that are used, they're using in Capgemini.
Can you hear me at the back? Is that alright? So I'm just going to talk about my career and then sort of how I got into cloud/AWS and transitioned from web design and development into that really. Normally people would go into sysadmin background and then go into like platform engineering, but I got a little bit bored about development and decided to change it. started out web design development, really great course, lots of stuff that I've learned in Northumbria I've used in the real world so far. I did a placement year at a company called Business and Decision. That was like mainly set around the Microsoft stack, like C# and .NET languages. Before I went on my placement, I was getting 2.2s, maybe scraped the old 2.1. Committed. Okay, I'll probably tell you. And then after my placement, I was getting mainly firsts, really straightened me out, really focused me, which is great for my career, to be honest with you. I'd really recommend doing a placement if you get the opportunity. So end of uni, really, I started a little freelance business. Friends have changed over the years. At first, couldn't get any web development business, mainly graphic design, and then now I'm doing content management systems for businesses. The latest one is for like a soapbox company that's just started in Blythe. A friend of mine runs that, so we're building a content management system for him, just like a marketing site. But yeah, that's sort of grown over the years, you know, from really small clients to now getting bigger and bigger. And then when I graduated, joined Accenture as a web developer. Because of my placement year, I had far more experience than maybe 90% of the intake, which basically definitely a really good step. And I started leading teams there for web developments, three or four web developments, built a couple of hybrid apps, one was for the NSPCC, really, really good, so on and so forth. And then we went to a graduate course school, and I think because I was a bit more focused than everyone else, I came first. Then MD moved into TechArc, which was basically where I started to get into like, the cloud and start to brush up on DevOps and stuff like that. So while waiting for my security clearance for HMRC account there, I set this really cool little remote 3D printing proof of concept, using Raspberry Pi and a hybrid phone app. Probably one of my favourite projects I've done so far. A 3 year career in IT, you'll probably get to work with different bits of innovation here and there, you know, maybe in between projects and stuff. Generally the more fun ones, so it's all the brand new stuff, all the new toys, it's pretty good. While at Accenture as well, I've got involved in some other little side projects, like I ran a year one network, so everyone that was like my intake and all the new stars and so on, they were, they would all go out for drinks, we'd all meet up, you know, network and stuff like that, that was really fun. And then became an advocate for mental health and LGBT too. So that was good. So it's nice to have something just outside your day job, you know, just to keep you interested. You don't get too bogged down with your work all the time. It's really nice to network with your peers as well. When I left there, I had a couple of weeks off, so I started another business called Coop Discount. It's essentially a content management system. We've now got six people involved. Probably going to look for investment later this year. We can start turning revenue. but it's all built on technologies and stuff, and you know, web development technologies that I've learned at Northumbria. You know, Angular, PHP, MySQL, and then that's all hosted using AWS and the cloud that I learned at Accenture. And then when I left Accenture, so I joined Nexor as a cloud architect, work along the innovation director. And this role was probably a lot more broader than my role at Accenture, because it was a lot smaller company. Now you'll find that if you work for a smaller company, your role will be wider. If you're in a bigger company, like Capgemini, Accenture, you'll be a bit more narrow. So that's really what you want. I tend to flick between both so far. At Nexor, just helped in re-architecting some of their solutions into using fully cloud-adopted technologies, using like AWS DevOps, like CloudFormation. But in the end, we could set up their new solution in 10 minutes, and it was all automated, so it was really powerful. And they were just in the cybersecurity space. So I learned a little bit about cybersecurity there, which was quite interesting. I think you learn that nothing's really secure when you're working in cybersecurity. And then I actually got made redundant from there. The company wasn't doing too well. And I always thought that I was never going to get made redundant being in IT. I was out of work for about 2.5 months, but I didn't just sit in my house, you know, pull my finger out. I built this cool little Grime soundboard phone app, which ends up like 10 a month in AdWords, which not a lot, but it was fun to do. And then, launched this estate tech. I was at an entrepreneur like meeting, really. Basically, they all get together and you know, they give you tips and advice on how to take you know, your little startup forwards and stuff like that. And I met another lad there who worked to create this online estate agency, essentially. It's a bit more to that. But I'm under an NDA, so I can't say too much. And he comes out of work. He gave me a nice big deposit and some shares in his business, so I started to build that. So that's good in getting there when I've got time. Really busy. And then joined Capgemini probably like 3 or 4 months ago, not too long ago. I was on the bench for a little bit, so I did my AWS certification. You know, in IT, you've constantly got to learn and you know, keep going forwards. What you know is like what you're worth, really. And then just so happened that I went down there and replaced a guy who was probably a bit more junior than myself. And then the other guy that I was working with ended up doing a runner and going contracted, so left me in shit. just trying to pick up all the apples and you know put them all together and reorganise and that. Now we're in a really good strong position moving forwards. But you know, for the HMRC to say that they're using fully AWS adopted architecture is quite unheard of. Feel like third party, not vendor locks, sort of strategy. But for this one, it's kind of like a little innovation project for them, so it's been quite lucky, really. It's been quite a fun project so far. It's been really good. And I'm starting to get involved in recruitment at CAP as well, tying in with like Dynamo. Have you anyone heard of Dynamo? Okay.
Is it the networking?
Dynamo group. So Dynamo is essentially a group of like directors of companies in the Northeast. There's HMRC directors on there, like Charlie Holt from Opencast. Loads of people really. It's a really great group. Bob Patton from Accenture, he's ex Accenture. Definitely want to join their network if you get a chance. Definitely have a look at that.
Yeah, can I just say something about that? Actually, it's not just organisations, it's academic institutions and schools as well. We're all linked together through the Dynamo network. So it's basically the Northeast is a massive hub, has a massive hub of technical experience, certainly in the digital and the construction sector, funnily enough. what that organisation does is it acts as a kind of a networking vehicle where you can speak to organisations, find out what's going on in industry, apply for funding together. So the university applies for funding with organisations that we're connected to through Dynamo. Likewise, organisations connect with organisations and apply for funding and do work through there as well. They have a networking event, I think about once a year, big event. I think this year it's hosted at Newcastle University. We've hosted it here before, and I think it's been hosted at Sunderland as well. Yeah, it has. So they're worth trying to get along to if you ever see them advertised there. If the next one comes up whilst you're still at university, I'll send you the link out and you can have a look.
Yeah, so in IT really, you know, like me, you might start in web design, you know, you might end up in cloud, you might end up somewhere else, you know, you might end up in, you know, some of the part of IT, AI, VR, something like that. Once you've got that core programming understanding really, it leaves you in a really good stead. You know, you can take that forward into anything you want. You know, we're so in demand at the minute. You know, in the Northeast there's over 2,000 IT jobs available. Every year there's only 215 students doing A-levels here. So, you know, there's quite a big gap there, and you can understand like how needed we are in IT. And yeah, your experience completely determines how much you're going to get paid, so never stop learning. If you're going to, you know, go down IT route, sign up to Pluralsight. If you've heard of Pluralsight, like, it's like £20 a month, and there's loads and loads of great videos on there. Most of my experience has been self-taught with Pluralsight. If I ever need to know something, a new technology comes out that, you know, you hear about while you're working, go onto Pluralsight, spend a week learning about it, and then you can use it up to like industry standards, so it's really, really good. And yeah, network. When I first joined Accenture, I think it was the first day, one of the MDs was just like, network, network, network. Everyone you meet, you're going to be with. You know, 3D career, you're going to see them all the time, you know, different places, different jobs. That's probably some of the best advice I've had. Just meet as many people and get to know as many people as you can. Definitely do that. Google everything. If you don't know what it is, get stuck, Google it. you don't need someone to tell you how to, say you've got a bug in your code, you don't need someone to tell you how to fix it, you need to Google it. And when you Google it, you'll learn a lot more, and you'll be invested.
Did I just say that we teach you the fundamentals, yeah? And then you can Google it and build on the skills. You still need your basics.
Oh yeah, 100% need your basics. You can't just go and Google it and then... yeah, you've got to build a strong core first.
Yeah, I don't want to be out of the job yet.
Yeah, I don't think you'd be able to go straight to Pluralsight and miss out uni. Like you need to have that, you know, initial building blocks. You know, do your placement year. But like after uni, after you've done your placement, when you graduate, get good, you know, get on Pluralsight. So yeah, Amazon Web Services, mainly what my job's around. It's the industry leader at the minute for cloud provider. I think we have. Well, they have like an 8% market share, is that about right? I think. Something ridiculously high level. So I've got this little video that's probably going to explain it a bit better. Okay, have you got speakers?
There should be speakers set up to the thing.
When you're working in retail or real estate, with financial data or photos, your business depends on application.
On the laptop, where you put your
applications
that run.
Okay. You can see it pretty well.
Yeah, it's quite loud.
Can you hear it though? Yeah. You hear it at the back.
Reliably and securely at a cost that scales with your needs.
So cloud. Yeah, I'm not sure. Is
Whether you're working in retail or real estate, with financial data or photos, your business depends on applications that run reliably and securely at a cost that scales with your needs. Amazon Web Services provides a complete set of cloud computing services accessed via the internet to help you build and run those applications. At AWS, we provide compute, storage, and database services which enable your organization to quickly provision the IT resources it needs without significant capital investment. Pretty much everything you would want to do in a traditional data center is available with AWS. But all our services are available on a pay-as-you-go basis with no upfront capital expense. Instead, you'll find highly durable storage services, low latency databases, and a suite of application development tools which you'll only pay for as you're using them. Since AWS has hundreds of thousands of customers across 190 countries, you'll also benefit from our economies of scale, delivering powerful resources at a low operational cost. Capacity planning becomes easier too. In a traditional data center, launching a new application can be a bit of a gamble. Provision too many servers and you could end up wasting money and time. Provision too few and your customers might not have the best experience. With the ability to add and remove capacity elastically, your application can scale up to meet your customers' needs and scale back down again quickly, saving you money. And while we could talk about provisioned I/O performance and durability statistics all day long, we often hear from customers that the biggest performance improvements come from their own team's ability to deliver innovative new features to market more quickly. With AWS, development teams are able to focus on adding differentiated value for their own customers rather than on the heavy lifting of racking and stacking servers. This helps drive innovation by making new ideas feasible that were once out of reach. Experimentation is fast and low risk, making it possible to try out new projects which would once have been constrained by cost or resources. Successful experiments can go into production quickly, and you won't have to live with the collateral damage or cost of those that didn't pan out. In today's interconnected world, it's possible for any company to have end users across the world. From our multiple geographic regions, AWS helps businesses serve their customers globally without the need for expensive, time-consuming, physical geographic expansion. In a few clicks, you'll be up and running. Reinvent the way you interact with technology with Amazon Web Services.
So just to mention really, if you do stay as a web developer now, you're probably going to need to do some cloud work at some point. You know, look into the AWS developer certificate, because a lot of companies are going to be wanting AWS services that will tie into your development work. So definitely worth looking at that.
Josh, how much does it cost to get certified?
It's my solutions architect one. I think it was just under 200. I think that's about right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Associate was it?
Associate. $150 for the exam.
Yeah.
And then training on book front.
Yeah. You can do all the training on Pluralsight. Probably can do Pluralsight reference. Yeah, should be on commission. let's deploy a website and I'll show how easy it is. So I've got over it, got a little HTML5 application, which is just an index page. Says HTML5 on it and then it zips up in a folder. So if we go onto AWS, and this is using a service called Elastic Beanstalk.
Can you see that on the screen?
So literally all you have to do on Elastic Beanstalk to host an application on them, create your application, call it whatever you want. And then create a new environment. I'm going to create a web server environment. Check that you can use the URL for it. We're going to use a pre-configured PHP platform, just one I'm most familiar with. And then we'll upload our source code. literally all it takes to get a web server up and running with your code. So, you know, coming from a web design development background, if I knew about that when I was in your shoes, it would have made my life so much easier. you can go and put together like a portfolio site, you know, really easily, really cheaply, all on AWS, stuff like that. And if you use their small compute environment, it'll probably cost you like £6 a month or something like that, just to run it, because you'll have no traffic really. So really good to look at that. So that's just set up all that environment for us.
So you didn't have to register like a domain or anything, it's like a test domain?
Yes, so pretty
much.
Did,
but you didn't talk through it.
Okay.
You went right past really quick.
So the domain really is, like that's my custom bit there. But you can go and put a DNS in front of that if you wanted to, through AWS. So you could have, you know, like joshedwards.com put into this domain if you wanted to.
What you say, it's like £6 a month?
It's really cheap.
Okay.
I think, unlike traditional web hosts as well, you only get charged for what you use. So if you turn your instances off, you don't get charged, or you get charged very little, so you're not getting charged the full £6 a month. But if you got your website switched on, then you'll get charged £6 a month. So we will go through the different tiers and charges next week to try and give you a better understanding of that. So it's better than a traditional web host because you can turn things on and off, and they're still there on the cloud, just nobody can access them, but you're not being charged full price for them all the time if you're not using them, which is really handy. You kicked off there. So looking forward, really, you know, more and more services are adopting the cloud, and if they're not already in the late to the market, really. You know, some things I can see happening, like remote processing, all your gaming going in the cloud. You know, maybe you'll have a tablet that just does all your remote processing in the cloud. You'll always have a really fast, you know, the best latest technology because it's all in the cloud. You just have to connect to that on the internet. Future sales going that way at some point. You know, any you know, solutions and stuff like that you do put in the cloud, you can have up and running in minutes for, you know, utilizing like new DevOps like strategies. All of you talking about DevOps?
I will.
Yeah. So find out a little bit more about that in a minute. Hot topics outside of the cloud, really. Internet of Things. There's a website called If This Then That. You want to look at that if you've got an Alexa. All your connected devices, that's what they call it, isn't it? Augmented reality, virtual reality, you know, all coming to the brain. Big data, robotics, AI, fintech, biotech. All really, you know, interesting topics that you could all get into from, you know, doing this course with a bit of training, a bit of extra practical activity.
Hopefully at the end we might have a chance to have a bit of